Hi everyone, welcome here. Today I'm going to show you how to connect your SP Racing F3 flight controller to your receiver through a iBus connection. Previously in PWM you need this much of wire to connect your flight controller to a receiver, but in iBus you need just a single wire, and this wire comes with this PWM wire. If you look closely at the PWM connector, you can see all these wires are separated from each other and all use a separate servo lead. Except this one, you can see in this servo lead there are three wires, one is white, red and a black in a single servo lead, so it need this cable only, so we have to eliminate all these cables. After eliminating this, it will look like this. In the flight controller we got two port, this is IO1 port and this is IO2 port. I marked it one dot and this is two dot. So this IO2 port situated at the left of this arrow. You can see this is the arrow and this IO2 port at the left of this arrow. So we need to connect this cable to this IO2 port. That's it, the connection is done. Now connect this servo lead to your receiver. In I6B or I10B receiver you will find these two extra ports. This is for sensor port and this is for servo port. You can see there is also label as servo and sensor, and these both ports are iBus port. So you need to connect this cable in one of this port. I am using the servo port, and this is the orientation of connection. And this white signal wire is going to place to the outermost side of your receiver. So this is the signal wire, this is power wire and this is ground wire. And if you connect it to the sensor port, then also you need to connect this way. White port is going to face to this notch. You can see this is a notch, this is the signal wire, and all of your connection is made. That's now if you are using this X6B receiver, then what you need to do, attach this connector to your iBus port. This is your iBus port, you can see there is a label as iBus. And now connect this pin to here. This yellow one is your signal wire, this is your power wire and this is your ground wire. So this yellow is going to connect to your white wire. You can see the yellow is connected to the white wire, the red to the red and the black to the black. Now go to the computer. First connect your flight controller. Next go to ports. Here you need to enable this UART3 serial RX and then press save and reboot. Now scroll down to receiver mode. Select this serial based receiver and here you need to select iBus and press save and reboot. Now go to receiver tab. So here you can see the throttle is working, yaw is working, pitch is working, roll is working, and these are auxiliary channels. And it's also very clean setup. So if you think this video is useful, then please subscribe to my channel and also please give a thumbs up and share this video. Thanks for watching.